again. And for today's video, I have for you another swatch and review. Like, it's been such a long time now ki maine yahan pe swatch and review nahi kiya kisi bhi polish ka. But when I came across this new brand now and their amazing range of polishes, I'm like, I have to share with you guys. And which brand we're talking about? We are talking about none other than Har Koi. I'll mention the name on the screen in case I'm pronouncing it wrong or something like that, and I'll also put a screenshot of their Insta page so that you can recognize it by seeing the brand logo and everything na, ki which brand I'm talking about. Now, I came across this brand when they contacted me for PR and they sent me a beautiful PR. Let me show you. So this is the PR they sent me. This is their Advent Calendar Diwali Edition. And can you see how beautiful it is, you guys? And this is what it looks inside. Like, of course, you get like a leaflet. And you get 20 surprises over here. Like, each day starting from Dashera till Diwali. You can each like, you can open each number ka package on that day and you can get like what's inside. Because there are a lot of things inside, different things na. Since Diwali is over, this advent calendar is over, unfortunately, so we are not talking about this. What we're gonna talk about is the polishes that I got inside this advent calendar. I got almost 30 new polishes and they were like ranging from all sorts of textures and finishes. Like, everybody can find something for themselves. So I thought, let's share with you guys, put all the swatches so you can like compare and see whatever you wanna buy and get sort of a review over here. So that's what we're gonna do. Now let's see the swatches first, and then we'll talk about all the good stuff like the price, the availability, about the brand and everything at the end of the video. So you go ahead, watch the swatches and I'll catch you at the end. So for the swatches, now since there are a lot of different textures and finishes, I've segregated the polishes like according to their finishes. So there are like four categories you'll see once I put the swatches. Starting with creme polishes, which is their nail serum collection. Now these polishes not only make your nails look good and colorful, they have some hydrating and repairing properties as well, because they contain cucumber water, glycerin and some resurrection plant extracts. Now let's see the swatches. Starting with the first color, that is Muted Coral. Now this is straight up dusty brick orange creme shade. I have used many oranges. I do have many oranges in my collection, but nothing like this dusty light brick orange shade. Now formula of these polishes is also pretty good because they just glide on your nails, self-levels and get opaques in almost 1 to 2 coats. Now these polishes dry in decent amount of time and I really love how rich and creamy they look on my nails. Moving on to the second polish, which is Purple Grey Evening. Now this is like a dark grey polish with brown undertones. This polish is an exact replica of the previous one when it comes to the formula. It glides on your nails, it is self-leveling, but I believe it is less opaque than the previous one. You require at least 2 coats of this polish and if you have longer nails, you might require a third one. The third shade is called Dull Pink. Now it's a straight up pink, vibrant pink color but with strong purple undertones. Now this is a sort of color which makes your nails look like really delicate and feminine. Formula wise, it's an exact replica of the previous two polishes, but I was surprised to see how opaque it is. Like, you can get the opacity, full opacity in just 2 coats. The last shade in this collection is the Lime Tree. Now this is a very dusty pista green color and probably my favorite out of all four. Now this color reminds me of that Amul milk in pista flavor. Now I almost wanted to drink it. It looks so beautiful and flowy on my nails. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be using this color a lot in my nail arts. Moving on to the second category, it has like a mixture of different finishes and textures. Now, I have kept them in the same category because these polishes can be used on their own as well as toppers. So now let's see the swatches. The first polish in this category is Pink Jelly Flake. Now, as the name says, it's a jelly polish with a tint of pink and have like different iridescent shards inside it. Now, this is a polish which does not get fully opaque. Since it's a jelly, it does get deeper in shade as you increase the coats. Now, I've applied 3 coats here and I really love the look of it. Using this polish, you can definitely do the classic French tip design. I mean, you can use this polish to give that wash of pink to your nail beds. The next shade in this collection is Slate Blue Shimmer. Now, this is again a deep grey color, the similar one to the creme one, but it has a beautiful pink shimmer running throughout it. Like, it shows better when you apply it on your nails, and when you move your nails, you can see that pink shimmer shifting throughout your nail. Now, it does take like 3 coats to get fully opaque, but as I said, these polishes have such a smooth and light formula, it does not feel heavy at all. The next shade is called Gold Statue, and true to its name, it's like molten gold in a bottle. Now, this polish has golden particles in a tinted base. Now, this is the sort of polish that you can use as topper, but keeping in mind that it has a tinted base, it might alter your base color, or you can use it on its own. Now, it does not get fully opaque. You can still see some of your natural nail underneath, but it looks beautiful. The last polish in this category is called Black and Gold Statue. It is of the same family as the previous one, but this one has more of a greenish black tinted base with golden and that same greenish black particles inside it. Again, this can be used as a topper, keeping in mind it has a tinted base, or on its own, like it has better opacity than the gold one. Moving on to the third category, these polishes are like straight up toppers. They have different size particles suspended in clear liquid. You'll understand it better when you see the swatches. The first shade in this category is Red Polka. This polish has different sizes of red hexes suspended in a clear base. When you apply it over any base color, it looks like red dots, hence the name Red Polka. I have paired this with the shade The Lime Tree, and guys, I am obsessed. Though I don't deny that getting the bigger hexes on the nail was a bit tricky, but I believe after applying a single coat, I can take out the polish, fish out the red hexes and place it on my nails. That will look good too. The second shade is called Blue Polka, and it is an exact copy of the first one except the fact that this is in blue color. I have paired this shade with the Purple Grey Evening shade from the Nail Serum collection, and as I said, you can like take out a little bit of polish on the paper, fish out the bigger hexes and place it on your nails physically and just top coat it and you'll be done. The last category is again of toppers, but of a different kind. Like, these are those toppers which can give like a colorful sheen to any creme or matte polish, but they are a little different. Like, before using them, you have to shake them vigorously to mix the pigment and the clear liquid so that you can get a seamless blend and then application. The first shade in this category is called Gold Enchantment. Now, this polish contains shimmery gold particles suspended in a clear base. Now, this is a true topper in the sense that since it has a clear base, it does not alter the base color. It just adds a beautiful golden shine, and when you shift your nail, you can see the shifting of that shimmer as the light hits it. The next shade is called Violet Enchantment. Now, if you see it from afar, it looks pretty similar to the previous one. But it's a tad bit different from it in the sense that this one has like silver shimmer suspended in the clear base along with some bigger violet particles. Like you can see when I apply it on my nails, I have paired it with dull pink shade and you can see like I have bigger particles, bigger violet particles on my nails as well along with slight silver shimmer. The last shade is called Copper Enchantment and it's an exact replica of Violet Enchantment except the fact that it's in copper color. It has that silver shimmer in a clear base along with copper particles this time. So yes guys, these were the swatches of all the 13 polishes that I got. There were some beautiful toppers. If you know me, you would know that I'm not a huge fan of toppers, but I believe I can use these toppers for sure in my nail arts. And again, if you know me, you would like can guess which will be my favorite finish. Yes guys, I love those nail serums, like those creme polishes. Oh my god, the green one was so beautiful and we have such few green polishes in the world now, so every single green polish counts, right? Now let's talk about the brand a little bit. For me, this is a particularly new brand and they are vegan, they're cruelty free, their polishes are I believe 13 toxin free, which is like a big thumbs up. And the biggest like USP of their brand is they fight against colorism. Yes guys, this is their like main agenda of doing that. Every color is beautiful when it comes to your like skin now. Every color is beautiful, every color polish looks beautiful on every color of skin and everything. So I really like this concept of theirs and I believe this is another reason you should give this brand a try, because not many brands do that, right? And I'm really happy that brands are coming with such things now. The second thing, like though advent calendar of theirs is discontinued, it's not available any longer, but you can keep an eye on this brand because I'm pretty sure they are gonna bring a lot of new stuff, new ideas to Indian nail polish market, because I believe this is the first brand I ever saw doing an advent calendar, that too including nail polishes. So I'm pretty excited and I'm looking forward to what new this brand is gonna bring to us. Now talking about the polishes, each of these polishes like come individually packed in these beautiful cardboard boxes. Like these boxes are so colorful and graphic designed, like each box ke piche na there is an image which depicts the name of the polish. Like here the polish is gold statue, so they have provided like an image of the statue. The second one is having blue polka dots, so all over the box there are polka dots and everything. So this is such a cute idea na, instead of like ek color ka packaging na, they have given such beautiful graphics over the entire packaging. I really love this. I'll put up a picture of all the cardboard boxes because they are so pretty to miss. Now these polishes retail for like 200 rupees and you get 8 ml of product in the bottle. They are available on their official website, which I'll mention down in the description box below, and also on Amazon. Again, a direct link will be down in the description box below, and don't worry, it's not sponsored at all. I'm not getting paid to say all this. So yeah, that's about these polishes. I really enjoyed using them, and guys, if I tell you a secret, the creme polishes, the nail serums, they're watermarking. So there is another brand for you guys whose polishes can water marble. And yeah, this is about this video. If you enjoyed this swatch and review, don't forget to give this video a big fat thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, ring that bell to stay notified for new content. And as I always say guys, maintain social distancing, stay safe, get vaccinated, be kind to the animals around you. Keep yourself hydrated and yeah, I'll catch you in my next one. Bye-bye.